this doesn't do what it was doing last night. I really hope my controller's not messed up. Guess where we're going? Oh, there are side quests, aren't there? Picked up some. I did a couple of them already. Bridge at Northern Plains. Okay. Seems fine.
Calm yourself. Haste will only lead you to making an ill-timed mistake. An unstable heart is the worst armor one can have.
No time for that, Vice. I gotta get to Yona.
It's one shade, so why is it not here? We're in the Northern Plains. Do they mean this? You know, there's a bunch of bridges. Like, there's only one functional bridge, but... There's one down there, but... I would have assumed that they meant this bridge, but... Maybe not? I don't know. There's also, like... I saw something crawling around down here. Okay. What one are they speaking of? What about that one? What about that one? What about I don't know. The bridge. The functional one. No. There's nothing else at the functional one. I would have seen it. For sure. It's not at the functional one, I can assure you. Maybe they mean up on top? I doubt it. They aren't being very specific. I would have thought, I would have definitely thought that they meant the functional bridge, not this. But literally, we were just there, and there's like all these little shades, but not like one shade, you know? It wasn't just one shade. So no, they don't mean this. They don't mean the one over there either. So I don't know what they mean. I'm in the right region. I know I am. These are the Northern Plains. It's so ridiculous when games do that. I really don't get it. What do you mean the bridge, game? What do you mean? Oh no, it's pulling to the left again once in a while. I don't get it. Oh, here. You mean here? Is there like one big one here? No? Do you mean here? There's little ones here, but there's not just one. Bridge, huh? There's no bridge over here. Or just keep running around doing nothing. until we find it. We've gone every single thing it could be. I can assure you there's no bridge here. We just crossed a bridge. And there wasn't anything there. Just a bunch of little ones when we fought them and they're dead. I don't know what this game wants. This is dumb. Why would you send me on a mission when there's nothing fucking here? Dispatch the Shade that has taken up residence near the bridge in Northern Plains. However, it seems the Shade isn't always there. Well, that's stupid. Why the hell would they fucking do that? That is pathetic, game.
However, by the way, not always there.
Fuck you. Fuck you, game. Basically, I just have to... Damn chords. Could you please get on the goddamn bridge? Move your ass! Get on.
However, it's not always there.
Not always there, then why do I have to kill it? Bunch of little ones. Hey, No big shade, I don't understand.
Damn it! Your armor's too strong!
They seem to have developed some manner of bodily protection. It seems these creatures, too, follow the prescripts of evolution.
Then I'll just have to overpower them!
Oh, come on. It's not here. Think with Vice like picking on her choice of dress so much, she'd be like, you know what, I'm just gonna just change into something that covers a little bit more, and then maybe he'll leave me alone. Maybe she's not embarrassed when she says when she gets mad at him. Maybe she's just like, fuck you. Everywhere what I want, bitch. If I look like Aussie, I look like Aussie. That's what she was thinking. Yeah, where would I want? We're getting nowhere fast. You think Vice would embarrass her by saying, hey, you're crack showing? No, she wouldn't be embarrassed. No. She likes throwing it off. Must be. I can't read her mind. I just read what she's wearing. bridge at the northern plant. The big shade doesn't seem to really exist. Get on! One more time, and I'm just gonna move on to something else. Be around here is could you please steer in the direction I like you? Get on. I don't know how many times I told it. I'm not counting it. Get on. I'm pressing O. Get on. O. Circle. Nothing. It's like, never mind then, game. See it whenever we're near there, I guess. Then we'll defeat it, but it just doesn't seem to be there when it's supposed to be. We're not doing that. And, oh, we're not doing that either. Grocer's child has been stricken with a mysterious illness after playing with it. Oh, yeah, we gotta look for clues. Okay, we gotta talk to the kids. There's a kid over here, isn't there? Old lady. No kids right now? They're in town, by the way. Hello.
Things have... Some kids like to play in the northern forest. We're not supposed to know, but everybody does. Man, I wish I could go there.
I wish I could leave this place. I heard there's a scary curse on all the forests in the world. And the bigger the forest, the scarier the curse.
How about buying something?
How about leaving me the hell alone?
Totally cursed him. That's why he's sick. Everyone told him not to play in there, but he did anyway.
It appears something happened to the child when he entered the northern woods. I believe that area is more commonly known as the Forest of Myth.
You think there's actually a forest curse?
I will withhold judgment on such things. For now, we should visit the place and see for ourselves.
All right, to the Forest of Myth then.
Well, that didn't work.
Everything in working order?
Yeah, Vice. I'm good.
Your health is diminished. Do be more careful next time.
Forced in math. I think that's the Forest of Myth, right? Northern Plains first. They said Northern Forest, so I mean that would make sense. Get on! Jeez! Fuck you! Never mind. I'm gonna walk there. See if I give a shit. Jeez! How rude!
Home of that blasted dream.
Yeah.
Truly a nightmare I hope never to experience again.
Oh, hello. How are things? You want to know if anything unusual is happening? Well, I have been feeling a rather strange presence whenever I visit the Divine Tree.
The Divine Tree?
It's a legendary tree that exists in the heart of our village.
Did you investigate the cause of this presence?
Not really, no.
And why not?
Well, we're not really supposed to go near the tree, except for prayer.
And why is that?
I don't know. It's just how things have always been.
Weird. I hear you. Everything seems normal here.
We appear to have hit a dead end. Say, what is that on the ground?
Just some funny-looking berries.
Ah, poisonous ones, I'd wager.
Well, I'm sure not gonna eat them and find out.
A breath. A tree. Why do we seem to encounter nothing but odd people lately?
You should talk, Vice.
As if Grimoire Vice is capable of spouting such nonsense.
No comment.
Hang on. I don't think it's done.
It's the density of her talents.
Does that mean it'll tell us what we want to know? That'd be nice.
Scattered here and there across the blackness. Kind words, difficult words, amorous words, all sparkling in the dark like jewels. Words were few now, but time was shorter. Hearing the words in desperation, the tree turned to the sky. "This is wrong," whispered a tree in the voice of wind through the leaves. "This is not how it was supposed to be. The plan has failed." Once, long ago, the tree had remembered everything about the world. This was its task, its function, its purpose. It shivered with something approaching joy as it collected the memories of mankind. This was no accident. Emotions were as much a part of the tree as root and bark. Memories collected like dew on the thick green leaves of the tree. And once they were formed, a web that spanned the entire world. Words collapsed into sunlight before passing through leaves and into the pool of memory. From the pool, the worlds joined together to form colonies. The colonies united into whirlpools of light, and the light coalesced into stars. Each star was like a child of the tree, and it loved them all. Look at my memory. A child is here, brought low by disease. He is far too young to have suffered so. Thin beyond words, the boy's skin is a shade paler than the bleached sheets upon which he lies. His parents no longer visit him, for they cannot bear to watch him suffer. The doctors have long since surrendered his fate to the gods. The boy, too, has abandoned hope. Strange emotions, weariness, hatred, swell within the dark recesses of his young heart. He tries to reject the black terror that germinates in his body, but no amount of effort or tears can drive the invader away. He has long ceased to resent his parents and doctors. Once he did, but now his pain is so great that there is little room in his heart to think of others. Only one person brings the boy comfort. A healthy young girl with tan skin and deep blue eyes. She is a beacon of brightness and light in the boy's world. Her very presence is a comfort to him. But he is unable to look upon her face. Whenever they meet, the boy, filled with loathing for his own state, soon his loathing eats away at what joy he receives from the girl's visits. The girl will stop coming. He knows this, as every waking moment is spent in fear of this day. He thinks that if he could talk to her, if he could tell her all of his feelings, this might not be so, but this conversation never happens. The girl disappears. The boy dies alone. The tree scoops up his memory and carefully stores it within itself. Etched upon it is a single word, envy. Look at my memory. There's a female warrior. Her greatest enemy is a beast with red eyes that she cannot fully comprehend. When she strikes it with her sword, it turns into a pillar of salt and dies. But when the white smoke clears, a new enemy arises. And another. The warrior knows that her struggle is folly, but fighting the unending stream of enemies fills her with a sense of joy and purpose. Somewhere deep in the warrior's drug-addled mind lies a vague memory of a daughter. Perhaps the child exists only in her head. The dying remnants of a powerful dream. She does not know. Friends and fellow warriors come and go. Some flee in terror, some are eaten. She began the fight with 63 companions, but most are gone now. The warrior's body shudders. She does not understand why at first. By the time she hears a fierce, low sound, the arena is already enclosed in darkness. Looking up, the warrior sees a beast so large that it blots out the sky. She is laughing. She has been doing so far long as she can remember. Covered in blood and dirt, the warrior laughs. She laughs and laughs until the town that contains her daughter collapses into a pile of dust. The memory has been stored for a long time. It is etched with a single word, loss. Look at my memory. A red dragon falls from the heavens. Ah, the memory has been lost, a shame. It was a favorite of mine. After many centuries of existence, the tree saw that its carefully labeled memories were beginning to dwindle. When seemingly infinite, the memories now seemed ready to disappear forever. The tree did not feel sadness at this. Grief was an emotion beyond its comprehension. It did, however, have the distinct feeling that something was missing. The mountain of memories it had so carefully assembled had disappeared. The tree stretched its branches as far as it could, but new memories refused to flow. The pool of memories was a black, empty pit, a hollow place where life had once flourished. The tree had lost its purpose. There was nothing to be done but shift through the few remaining memories littering the ground under its branches. This is why the tree was pleased when the young man and his companion entered the room. Darion, well, this place is gloomy as hell. The room Darion had entered was almost completely empty. All he could see were a few crystals scattered haphazardly on the ground. Picking up one of the crystals and peering into it, Darion suddenly saw a familiar sight. It was the Forest of Myth, its villagers, prisoners of their own dreams. I apologize, the tree thought. This is all that remains. As Darion stared at the jewel, bewildered, a voice suddenly called out from the depths of his mind. The voice implored them to listen. It was an order, following it was mandatory. Abruptly, the pair realized they must listen. They must listen. Vice says, look here, look there. A small shadowy presence appeared from beneath the floor. It appeared to be your shade. The shade grasped several jewels in its hand. More jewels tumbled out of its mouth like shards of broken teeth. Sights and sounds tinkling from each other, one before vanishing forever. The creature was abusing their memories, treating the precious objects like a collection of cheap playroom toys. Vice says, this shade appears to be consuming the memories. Darion says, these things eat memories? The tree extended a branch toward Darion. Without a second thought, Darion brought his blade down on the shade, tearing its stomach wide. Jewels burst from the shade and poured across the chamber floor. Look, thought the tree, there is the conviction memory I had lost, and satisfaction and many others as well. Yes, this is good. The tree opened its mouth and attempted to speak, but no sound emerged. A millennium of silence and solitude had caused the tree to forget certain things, but rather than be upset, it greeted the development with good cheer. Focusing on all this power on a riddle of speech, the tree formed a kind of makeshift vocal cord and tried again. Ahem. I implore... It spat out a glimmering green jewel. One more time. I implore you. There we are. What was the color of the lost envy?
You let it slip through your fingers.
It was green, what?
Come on, we have to go back to that stupid land of words again?
Bullshit.
Black, I don't know. I don't know. spoke. This shade was, has intelligence and emotion. Who cares? Theron brushed Vice's comments aside from her sword slice through the shade's right arm. The shade extended its remaining arm towards Darion. I must touch him. I must make contact. The moment its fingers brushed against Darion, the tree felt a warm sensation begin to burn. Something hot coursed through its fingers, up its arm, and out of its entire body. It was emotion, more than the intensity had felt in centuries. The tree cried out in surprise and joy. 1,000 years alone. 1,000 years in quiet contemplation. The tree felt like it was going to break apart. For long centuries, the tree had been alone, its heart sealed with heavy chains, but no more. New powerful emotions began to take hold, causing the heart to tighten and lighten. This was more than the simple emotions it had been designed to feel. It was the beginnings of a soul, and the young man was the key. This was a promise made long ago. This was how it would be released. The tree began to throb in pain, a new and unpleasant sensation, but the time was not yet right. I implore you, many were lost by the warrior who fought the red-eyed beasts. Okay, I am not. Oh, come on. I'll say 23. I don't know. See, I don't know. It doesn't even... Oh, for God's sakes. I'm gonna pick a random number, I guess, because I didn't see anything. I read where it said to read it. It's not there. There's no clue there. It was brown! What the hell? We did it, though! We did it last time!
Come on, we have to go back to that stupid land of...
But the answer wasn't fucking there! The girl's eyes, huh? Oh, I assure you, they won't even mention the girl's eyes. say Brown Eyes, I missed it. I think it did. It doesn't say anything about how many people. Okay, I'm gonna have to guess the number then, because it's sure as heck not telling me yet what I need to know. 63, I just saw it. Her eyes were brown, so let me pick brown again. Okay, riddle time is over. I'm gonna kill the stupid shade once and for all. Something round and shiny fell in the open stomach and scattered it to the floor. The key, cried the book. Secure the key! The man's sword slowed. Time began to dilate around them. Stretching and slowing time is essential. Next word must be heard. The words exploded and became difficult to discern their meaning. The pool of memories began to crack as if blackness burled its way into the wall. This world is falling apart. How can a world be letters? I implore, most important thing, world. Really? Light was complete. The memories disappeared. The trees had didn't begin to dissolve. As the letters slowly faded, Darion was drawn back to the real world. The tree was satisfied.
What in the... I never realized shades were capable of rational thought.
I don't care if they can tap dance and play the fiddle. I just want to kill him without all this hassle.
With the tree defeated, we no longer have to worry about being buried in its world of letters. Unless, of course, time itself begins to rewind.
What next? Check to see if the letters arrived from the younger brother.
Maybe Popol has found some information about the Shadow Lord. Let's drop by the village.
Very well.
Solve the mystery yet?
No, we got nothing.
Too bad. Hey, what's with those berries?
What, these? We picked them up over by that huge tree. I thought maybe.
Give me.
No!
Starving.
You don't eat those, you'll get sick.
Are you mad? Those berries are clearly poisonous. Even one such as you can't hope to.
Damn, these are delicious.
Give what?
Well, in that case, I suppose I should try one.
But he falls over, okay.
I think Vice was right about those berries. Feels like somebody stabbed me in the gut.
And she had no problem with them.
Hey, what's wrong? Oh no, don't tell me you ate one of those berries. The love of trees, those things are deadly. Quick, take this antidote before you perish.
5 minutes later. It only took 5 minutes, huh?
Thought I was a goner there.
Are you an idiot? Didn't you see the lumps? The unusual colors? Only a child would attempt to eat something like that.
A child? Oh, crap. I bet that kid ate one of these berries.
Yes, quite possibly. And if the poison is this painful for you, I can only imagine what it would do to a small child.
Hey, Kaine, did you take the antidote?
Don't need it. God, those berries were amazing.
What the fuck is wrong with her?
The truly amazing thing is that your stomach is fouler than your taste in clothing.
If you had genitals, I would so chop them off right now.
You can give him an appendectomy. If he has an appendix.
This poison sucks. Still can't feel my arms and legs.
I feel great.
Man.
He's a weirdo.
Must have a cast iron stomach, Kaine.
The hussy's internal organs are as filthy as her mouth.
Why do you have to be such a shithead all the time, Buck?
It didn't even attempt to move. Not showing up. Stop. Get on! Jeez.
Ma'am, I think your child ate a poison berry. If you give him this antidote, he should recover.
Oh, thank you. I'll have him take it right away.
Glad to hear it.
And perhaps remind him not to eat foodstuffs he finds on the ground.
I knew it. This is what I was talking about.
Wait a minute, what do I have? Yeah, we can't do that, right? Yeah, we can't do that. Oh yeah, the map, yeah, never mind that one.
What have we got today? Which job should I give you first?
Learning a trade.
That trader in Seafront has another request. Well, he's more of a would-be trader, I guess. Anyway, he can fill you in. I wrote down the client's location on your map, so head over there to get the details.
Of course he's there. Oh!
You wanted...
Butt munch?
Which job should I give you first? Come back.
Oh.
to see you again. Looks like you're feeling better.
I can't give up on my dream that easily. Seasickness is terrible, but I've got a few tricks up my sleeve.
Oh, yeah?
Well, for one, I'm working on my own herbal cure. It's a bit of a work in progress, though. I'm not totally sure about the ingredients.
I see.
Hey, I don't suppose you'd mind getting an ingredient for me, would you? You can buy it from the Strange Thing store in Facade. I wouldn't ask, but you're the only guy I know who can get in there.
Sure, I can do that.
Great! The item I need is a mandrake leaf. Thanks so much.
The Strange Thing shop.
It's hard to believe there are plants that can grow in this desert.
Yeah, this'll never work.
How do you mean?
I mean, if plants could grow here, it would be full of them. God, books can be so stupid sometimes.
Have you ever planted anything before, Kaine?
Nope.
Well, then you don't know. You gotta try things out for yourself.
Indeed. Experimentation can often be the key to new knowledge.
You guys sure are a bunch of optimists.
Say, can you eat scorpions?
Indeed you can. Long ago, people operated food stands where they impaled the creatures on skewers and fried them whole.
Where did you learn that?
Who can say? I do not know. Some portions of the past are inexplicably clear in my memory.
Whatever, Gramps.
What was that, hussy?
Arutra.
Hey. Hey there. I'm in the market for a mandrake leaf.
Expected such a request from you.
Sorry, what?
Worries, we're all men here after all, yes?
What are you going on about? Well, whatever. Let's get this back to the client.
Arut.
It's you, eh?
Got your mandrake leaf.
Fantastic. Here's the money for the leaf and a little extra for all the travel. This is the key to my seasickness medicine. I just know it.
Next morning.
How's the medicine going?
Oh, it's, well, it's Interesting. I thought it would help my seasickness, but instead, I made an energizer of sorts. And believe me, my wife is thrilled.
I really didn't need to know that.
Look, I need to try again. Do you mind making another shopping trip for me?
Sure thing. Hopefully we'll have better luck this time.
Great! I need some toad oil from Two Brothers Weaponry at the junk heap. Apparently, if you purify the stuff, it's good for the nerves.
How could he accidentally make a sexual stimulant instead of a seasickness medication?
Calm down, Vice. Maybe it just happened.
They are completely different drugs, with completely different effects.
Hey, everyone makes mistakes.
One. There's only one now.
Welcome. How can I help you?
I need a vial of toad oil for some medicine.
Pulling an all-nighter, eh? Well, good luck with that, sir.
Huh?
All that shade slang must be tough. I bet you use this stuff all the time.
I have no idea what's happening, but whatever. Let's just get this back to the client.
Thank you.
He does do weird shit. He runs, it's just... Maybe it's just the way the game is. He's just like going back and forth. It's weird. I don't understand that.
Here's your toad oil.
Great. And here's your fee. This is the key to my seasickness medicine. I just know it.
Morning.
Hey there. Any luck with the new medicine?
Not quite. It seems this time I've somehow concocted a potent sleep prevention drug. With this, you could stay awake for a week straight. I call it Sleepy God.
Maybe you should quit this sailing thing and become an apothecary.
You know, that's not a bad idea. All right, then. From now on, I'm out of the trading business and opening a pharmacy.
Right. Well, good luck with that.
Batman certainly has a gift for odd medications.
Yep.
Imagine, a drug that lets you forego sleep for an entire week. Might you care to try it?
I'll pass, thanks.
Hey, buddy. You know a place called the Lost Shrine?
Yeah, I know it.
Listen, I'm what's called a botanist. That means I study plants. This is all probably way over your head, but just bear with me, all right, buddy? Anyway, this Lost Shrine place supposedly contains a very rare tree, and I'm looking for someone to go there and borrow a piece of its root. What do you think? Come on, buddy. It's just one little piece of root.
I'll do it. You have to stop calling me buddy.
Thank you.
It seems the ferryman has abandoned his post.
Guess that means we're walking.
How are we gonna walk there? How did we get there for that first time without going to the ferryman? I don't know why he does it, it's so weird. I'm going straight ahead, like, I'll just point him straight and he's like, walking like left and right, it's weird. It doesn't feel right.
Everything in working order.
yeah, Vice.
Fairman isn't there either.
Your health is diminished. Do be more careful next time.
How are you supposed to get there if the ferryman's not there?
Job should I give you? A postman wants you to get rid of some shades. It's getting pretty dangerous around here lately. I wrote down the client's location on your map, so head over there to get the details. Oh, which job should I give you first? Come back.
Curse these tired old bones.
Thank you.
Hey, did you hear the news?
What is it?
There's a giant shade in the southern plains, and they say it likes to eat postmen.
Really? I've never heard of shades eating people.
Yeah, well, people say the bodies look like they've been torn apart and chewed on. We're all too scared to deliver the mail with that thing around.
The shades are becoming more of a threat than ever before.
All right, I'll see what I can find.
I think I saw that thing once. I don't know if I can fight it or not. I might be able to.
Impossible! Who knew the shades had grown so large? And this close to a human settlement, no less.
Oh yeah, we can do this.
We probably ran out of stuff to eat up on the mountain.
Kaine, keep your guard up! I'm gonna make sushi out of this shit bag!
Such frightening enthusiasm.
Hey! Whoa! I need a new controller, must be.
Avenge the postman. Let's go report back.
He's walking and I'm not making a move. Yeah, I need a new controller. This sucks. He went left and I didn't tell him. He's going left and I'm not telling him to. Like, I'm moving the camera, but he's like, yeah, this sucks. I need a new controller. Can't really afford that right now either. That really sucks.
I killed the Shade in the southern plains.
Oh, thank you. Thank you. I don't know what to do about all the postmen who quit, but I guess I'll figure something out. Anyway, here's your reward.
I'm going to attempt to play my games like this until I can afford a new controller. I mean, unless I can hook up a PS4 controller and have it be okay, be okay with this game. I probably can. It's a matter of whether or not I can use a PS4 controller with, like, Doom Eternal, because that's the PS5 version that I have. So, yeah, maybe SOL there.
Which job should I give you? Apparently, the manor's butler has a unique shade he wants your advice on. Yeah, don't look at me. I wrote down the client's location on your map, so head over there to get the
Oh, come on. I hate that.
Master Emile, terribly sorry to disturb you, but I fear we have a situation.
What is it, Sebastian?
I was attempting to tidy up the study earlier, only to find that it has been occupied by a shade.
Shades really seem to love this place, huh? I take it you want us to kill the thing?
That may not be necessary, sir. It's not causing any trouble. It is simply sitting in the study.
It didn't attack you?
It did not, sir.
Well, I don't care if it's wearing a tuxedo and drinking a cocktail. If it's a shade, I'm gonna kill it.
Study, huh? What do you mean by the study, anyways? Place. Okay. I didn't intend to. Thank you. Hold on 1 second here. This feels weird because it's not the controller I normally use. I gotta try Doom Eternal a second, just see if it responds to the PS4 controller. Because I'm running the PS5 version of that game. I'm sure he wants me to fight a specific one, so... It feels weird playing it with a PS4 controller. I'm so used to that PS5 controller. I mean, at least it works the way it's supposed to, but... And this controller is smaller. Oh, there it is. This is what I'm after, right? Has to be. Okay. around here. This is weird. I thought he... See, he disappeared. The boss I was fighting, he disappeared. So what the hell am I supposed to do? There he is. Again. I don't know why I have to just to do this again. Killed it already. We killed it. Now what? I don't know. We're going back here again. I don't know. Thank you. There it is again. I don't understand. Like, I keep killing it. I jumped. We were supposed to kill them all. That was ridiculous.
Whatever you think best, sir.
Did we not do it? I don't understand. Investigate. We did. We killed literally everything down there. There's no other shades. God damn it, game. What the hell? That's fucking stupid. We didn't do anything wrong. We did it. Unless that wasn't the study, but I'm pretty sure it was. I don't know what you want from me, game. God damn it, that makes no sense. Get this. There's a bathroom there. That's it. I don't understand what this game wants. What do you want me to do, game? Tell me! We just fucking went there! We killed a boss! That was literally all we could do! It seems like it wants us to do a specific shade, but there's only one shade that really stands out down there, and we killed it! 3, maybe 4 fucking times! What the hell does it want? What the hell does this game want? I don't understand. We literally did everything right. You know, this is the only thing that's going to make sense, because we're just going to keep fighting the same boss over and over again if we fight down there. That's fucking ridiculous. I'm looking it up. I think this thing has to be bugged or something. There's nothing else you can fucking do here. Literally, There's absolutely nothing you can do. Nothing! Appears to be browsing the books on the shelves and has no interest in it. Are you fucking high? Who wrote this shit? He will not fight back when attacked. Are you fucking high? There was nothing there like that! There's nothing like that! I went through this entire goddamn thing. You told me that nonsense? Bull fucking shit! There is no goddamn shade browsing the goddamn books. Who did this goddamn walkthrough? He must have been high as fuck. You went through this entire goddamn thing! Where the hell do you fucking see this shit? This is literally the only thing here. That's not it. I'm not doing that. I don't see one studying books here. Do you? No, I'm not here either. Here. I don't see any goddamn book reading shades here. I insist. There's no... I'm not seeing one here. I'm not seeing one here. Thank you. I swear, this is so fucking stupid. I don't see a single shade reading a goddamn book. I don't know about some of the people that write these walkthroughs. They must be stupid as shit. I'm not seeing one! I'm not seeing one that the walkthrough is describing. Am I fucking blind? I don't understand. Blind? Did I just walk past it 5 million times? No. There is something clearly wrong here. Fuck, I'll fucking read it out fucking loud. Head to the study. We were just in there. Locate the shade. The shade appears to be browsing the books on the shelves and has no interest in attacking. What? 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 I didn't think a single goddamn one! A motherfucking fuck! Wasn't a single! Damn, why are you doing that? That fucking walkthrough is fucking bullshit, and it's lying. There's no way. That is a fucking troll! That is a fucking troll! The people in this goddamn thing are high too! It says you can't even hit it with magic. What do you mean? Fucking exist! What are you people fucking talking about? So I'm on another page. Visit Sebastian at the manor. Anytime after acquiring the stone guardian key. What? I think we must have. From the lost. Yeah, we did that. We have to get the shade that has appeared to study. If you annihilated the shade, that should keep the place safe for a while. I don't know what, it's not being very clear. A I'll watch this video. In the fucking study. Then what the hell are, where the hell are we? Oh my fucking god! It literally pointed somewhere else! I kept going to the wrong place. Because my map fucked me. My map literally pointed right where I was before. It did. Fucking done with this bullshit.
This must be the friendly shade. Still, a shade is a shade. Let's get rid of it.
Fucking bullshit.
Who told you you could live in my home? I'll crush you like a bug. Please be careful.
This is a rather tough nut to crack.
Oh, I'll crack it one way or the other.
It is as hard as freaking possible. Did we actually? Okay, we must have. Jeez. Took it long enough.
We killed that shade in the study. It was pretty tough.
Excellently done, sir. And now I must insist that you
didn't
take this
fight back either.
What was a shade doing in there in the first place?
I wondered that myself. Surely that creature lacks the intelligence to read books, yet I cannot imagine what else it hoped to accomplish there.
But anyways. Yeah, I can't go to the tree, right? And they don't know where that is, and I sense I don't want to do that, and I don't want to do that. And as far as the bridge, it hasn't shown up yet, so.
Welcome. Blacksmith.
Which job should I give you for? That butler from the manor needs your help. You should. I wrote down the client's look.
Butler again? Wasn't there a guy over a facade that needed my help? He seemed to. I'll visit there after I visit the butler again. Why didn't the butler just tell me there was another problem?
Welcome back, Master Emile.
Hello, Sebastian. I'm glad you're doing well.
Is something the matter, Butler?
I am searching, sir, for a way to restore Master Emile's body to its previous state.
Oh, Sebastian.
Regrettably, the above-ground archives are somewhat limited. According to my information, the records related to Master Emile are stored on the second basement floor. Things would be easier if I could delve into the manor's underground research facilities, but what with all the creatures there...
You want us to go down there and take out some shades?
Oh, no! I can't let you do that for me.
Emile, cut it out. We're friends. This is what friends do.
Hmm? Doing it. We were in the basement. We were not in the study. That just infuriates me that it literally came out and told me that this was the study. The map literally put it down here earlier. Or more that it actually pointed that the fact that we were here. It said basement. I mean, no, it just, like, our pointer was, like, where it says basement on the map. Except we weren't actually at the... Oh, whatever.
Thank you.
second floor, huh? Yeah, I think that's it.
What's this?
It appears to be a list of names and addresses. Perhaps they were employed at the laboratory. The text is half faded, but I see one woman used to live in a coastal town.
A coastal town? They must mean seafront.
The woman is most likely dead by now, but perhaps a search of her home will turn up something.
We're supposed to go to seafront now. It just kicks us out of the dungeon, the laboratory rather.
Maybe we'll learn something about Emile over in Seafront.
The paper mentions a house right above the entrance to a coastal town.
Right above the entrance? Gotta be.
Hey, mind if I ask you something?
Not at all.
Did anyone in your family ever do weapon research? Anything like that?
Yeah, actually, I think one of my older relatives used to do something like that. Why are you asking me this?
I'm looking into some of her research. You have any old records or anything?
Oh, man. Maybe? I don't know. If you hold on, I'll go take a look. Sorry about that. This is all I could find.
It's a letter. How curious. It is written in a language I do not recognize.
Yeah, we never could figure out what this was about, but it was important, whatever it was. She kept this thing under lock and key at all times.
It might be some kind of code that we can decipher back at the lab. You mind if we take this?
Go ahead. We've just been keeping it around because we don't know what else to do with it.
Let's go back and show this to the butler.
Thank you.
appears to be encrypted.
Oh, yeah?
It begins with "Dearest Emile," and then... Why, this appears to be a message for you, Master Emile.
A letter, is it?
To me?
"Dearest Emile, you do not know me, but I know you. My research has twisted your life in unfathomable ways. I tried to make up for this by serving as your mother. But I know now that my efforts fell woefully short. I would have done anything to save you from this fate. And you will never know how guilty I feel that I could not."
I remember her now. Hundreds of years ago, there was a woman who watched over me and my sister.
Hundreds?
The other scientists treated us like lab rats. But that woman... she was really nice. I think she kind of made me what I am today.
Your mother, huh?
You know, I didn't find a way to fix my body. But I don't care anymore. This letter helps me remember my mother. And that means more to me than anything.
I swear I will find a way to cure you someday, Master Emile.
One last time I'll go to Devila.
Doesn't look like I have any work.
Oh, I'm gonna go to the facade because I swear to God there was something there.
Oh, you.
Yeah. I worked it out. Shop here.
What's that guy is here?
Thank you.
Okay, never mind. You did have one, but it was one we already got and we couldn't finish. But we probably could. I don't care. I don't give a crap. I'm not crossbreeding plants to actually get the seeds she wants. I just won't do it. That doesn't sound like fun to me. We can skip it. And I guess now we're doing main missions.
Anything new about the Shadow Lord's Key, Popola?
You know, I was just going to talk to you about that. You remember the Airy, right?
Yeah. That depressing shell of a village?
Not so much anymore, it sounds like. I just got this letter from the village chief. Have a look.
My greetings to you and your village. I hope everything is going well. Our village has shut itself away from the world for far too many years, and we have therefore decided it is time to change our ways. As part of the endeavor, we have resolved to establish a shop within the village. It is now open for business, and I look forward to seeing your great many customers visit from all over the world. With regards to the sacrifice word we wrote about, one of our villagers claimed to know the meaning behind the term. You are more than welcome to speak to him on the matter, and as part of your visit to the Eyrie, I hope to hear from you again.
Sacrifice? Isn't that the name of one of the key fragments?
That's right. I've been trading notes with leaders from every town in the land.
You're amazing, Popola.
This entire affair strikes me as a bit too convenient.
I'm afraid Grimoire Vice is correct.
What do you mean?
The area has been shut off from the world for years, and now they've not only opened trade routes, but they freely exchange information about the Shadow Lord.
I agree. It seems rather unnatural and dangerous.
You're overthinking it. Besides, I don't care if it's dangerous. I won't get Yona back by just sitting around and waiting. If there are shades there, I'll just kill them and be done with it.
Oh dear.
Well, if that's the way you feel, I guess I won't stop you. Try speaking with the chief when you get there.
Okay, I know where the chief is. But I think I'm gonna grab some water. Just a minute. I'll be right back. Since we're going that way, we can at least see if that monster's there.
The area, huh? All right, let's go see the chief.
What a soul-crushing place. I cannot fathom that village setting up a mercantile. They must have truly opened their minds.
I'm gonna try going to the...
I have my doubts.
Aren't you glad to be going back home, Kaine?
Home? That place is a shithole.
Don't be so nervous, Kaine. We'll protect you.
I got me taken care of. Worry about protecting yourself.
Okay, so I guess we can't do that. Well, we gotta head to the bridge and see if the monster shows up. It's not showing up here, across the bridge. We'll see. Found it.
I've never seen a shade this large around here.
Be careful. This is a formidable foe.
One-handed sword labyrinths with spur.
Stupid trash getting in our way.
It's hard to imagine a shade being here. It's almost like it was waiting for us. They can't be that intelligent.
Oh, really now? Can you truly say so with all confidence? The tactics of the Shades grow more intricate with each passing year. It would not surprise me to see them setting elaborate traps for us before long.
We'd better wipe them out before they get too smart.
In any case, we won't be able to live in peace until we take out the Shadow Lord.
Okay, it's the Northern Gate. We have to go back there. We have the...
Killed the Shade at the bridge.
My daughter is dead. She passed while you were gone.
Damn.
Here, take this money. I won't be needing it anymore.
Damn. Nope. I'll be on my way. Into the area.
We haven't been here in a while. could live in such a dangerous place now, we messed up. Never mind.
Stay away! What will become of this village?
Is this where... Now you shut up.
There's no point in living anymore.
If you're not ashamed, then prove it.
Shades can't talk. How's that?
Hello? We're here from Popola's village.
It's all over.
We came to ask about the letter you sent.
Our days are numbered. Our village is doomed.
As cheerful as ever, it seems.
You're the one who wrote the letter, right?
I don't know about any letter.
What the hell is going on here?
It may be faster for us to take our inquiries elsewhere. Let us ask around. Someone must know something.
Oh, I thought that was a meme. I was like, what is that? It was like something peeking up.
The Shades attacked again last night. It's over. For us.
How do you survive if you don't leave your house to eat?
I don't believe in anything anymore.
What, you don't hunt, you don't...
Everyone will perish. Everyone. I'm too scared to trust anyone.
You. I know you.
You.
You. I know you.
Okay. Wait, there are people here. Are you kidding me? There are people here? What?
Welcome. Come back soon.
Make sure you stock up on necessities before heading out to hunt. Come back in.
A letter, huh?
Yeah, I think I heard something about that.
So, you know about the letter?
Maybe I don't. I'm not sure.
Which is it, man?
Oh, and if I may ask, are you friends of Kaine?
You could say that.
Ah, I've heard the rumors. Here to hunt shades, are you?
Indeed. Our aim is to defeat every last one.
Every last one? Everyone? Everyone? Everyone?
I was wondering... I love this spear. The spear, it rocks so hard. It just stabby stabs and it's just so quick.
Keep your guard up. Others are surely lurking near.
So much fun to use.
Goddamn time.
Wait, that guy's human.
You were distracted by the local welcoming party.
Want some help?
Kaine, the villagers are possessed.
But not all of them. Some are still human, so be careful.
You're over here. Not to jump.
Hey,
you even come here?
What's going on?
Don't be fooled by this lady. She's a shade.
No! No! You people are the monsters here!
Stay back, kid. Your sister is one of them now.
I don't care what she is. She's my sister, and I love her.
You're a shade. Damn it! She got hurt again. One more close-up of her assless panties. Don't hurt my Kaine! How dare you, lady or sir, or kid, or...
Kaine!
Kill them! Kill them now!
No! You've got to stop this! We're trying to save you from the Shades! Please, you have to stop!
Emil!
We need to get out of here! Kaine! Kaine, get up! Hurry!
Stop this at once!
Leave us in peace!
Villagers are under attack over there.
They're actually villagers over there?
Go away. I can't deal with this. Just leave me alone.
Died.
What could those black swirls be?
Fine until you showed up.
Get them.
Hmm.
villages. Is this beast a shade as well?
That thing sucked up the villagers.
No! If we keep this up, we're gonna kill them all! We can't let that happen!
Something from within, creature.
Is this the combined power of all those shades?
It will take more than a barrage of magic to stop us. The first to waver is the first to die. I sense magic coming from the center of that eye.
Wait! I think those are actual people!
Hold nothing back! Those are shades! The surrounding tentacles appear to deflect magic.
Well, if they deflect magic and they're in the way, then why am I still not hit? But I'll be tired. Yeah, now I'm hitting them. I don't.
Now, focus your magic on the beast's center.
That's what I've been doing. Here we go. See? Sweet. Behold, Emil, my weapon.
Look out! Something's coming!
Its weak point is located around the back. Try attacking it from above.
How do I have to do that?
I'll try to pin it down!
Emil!
Emil!
I'll keep it busy! You should be able to attack from behind! Go around and get it! Please, hurry!
Emil can handle this.
We
must circle behind the creature at once. You cannot harm it from below.
Oh, I have to go up there.
Are you there yet?
You must strike it in the eye. Escaping to the inner level.
I'm coming. Gotta catch my breath.
careful, Emil. It won't help anyone if we lose you here.
Killing it.
Come on, help me take it out.
I'm on it.
Okay, wait a minute, wait a minute. Stop. He's going Super Saiyan!
Emil!
He's gone. His instincts have taken hold. The ultimate weapon is being deployed.
What have I done? I killed innocent people. I killed them all.
But you saved us. If it wasn't for you, I'd all be dead. We owe you. It's all right.
What were you supposed to do?
Really? Don't look back.
We had best be off.
Yeah. Popol has found some information about the Shadow Lord. Let's drop by the village.
Very well.
Hey, Popola.
Ah, you're back.
Have you learned anything more about the Shadow Lord's key?
I'm sorry, but it's going to take me some time yet.
I see. Well, can I take something off your plate in the meantime?
Oh, how about this? You know the ferryman with the red bag, right? Well, he's been skipping out on work.
Oh, that's why I can't find him.
Can I ask you to go to Seafront and check on him?
Sure thing. This feels alarmingly familiar.
Ah, I'm sure that couple is merely having another one of their inane spats. Let us do our utmost not to get dragged into it this time,
What if Devil has stuff for us to do? Oh, it looks like it. That looks like she does.
Which job should I give you first?
A shade.
Apparently there are shades in the village? Well, don't just stand there. Go take care of them. I wrote down the client's location on your map, so head over there to get the details.
Oh, are you kidding me?
Which job should I give you? Come back when...
Say, are you available to discuss a certain sensitive matter?
What is it?
People are saying a shade has managed to enter our village. I was hoping you could track it down.
This isn't a very big place. Wouldn't we have seen it by now?
I had my own doubts at first, but there have been too many witnesses for me to ignore this matter any longer.
Too?
Apparently. I can't say for sure who's seen it or not.
I saw the monster right around here.
You did, huh? Can you tell me what the monster looked like?
It was over at the river, and it was huge and scary. I didn't like it.
Over by the river, huh? Let's go take a look.
The foul tendrils of the shades have finally extended into this village.
Fine. Then we find him and kill him.
Will it be that easy? Wonder.
What do you mean?
Would you be able to simply slaughter the people you lived amongst for so many years? Would you truly murder friends if you suspected them of being shades?
I wouldn't have a choice. Jonas not coming back to a village full of those things.
When the time comes, I pray you can follow through.
Thank you.
outside then.
If we can't go hunting, then we have to fish. Thank goodness for the sea.
The shades are much stronger now, especially the armored ones, so be careful.
Unless it's not this river.
Like a shade was ever here.
Perhaps the young lass misremembered the location.
Yeah, maybe. Kids aren't so great at stuff like that. Let's go ask her again.
What if she was the shade?
Saw the monster, but we couldn't find anything. Are you sure you saw it by the river?
I remember now. I saw it in the square in front of the library.
Really? Telling the truth?
Okay. Let's go check it out.
They just can't swim, right?
Why am I the only one?
There's nothing here. Guess the kid was wrong again.
This is a fool's errand. Even a young girl could hardly confuse a library gate with a river. Perhaps we should ask some of the other villagers.
Yeah, I guess.
A shade a few days ago, but I can't be sure. Whatever I saw, it wasn't much bigger than a kid.
Yeah, that kid is much more suspicious by the minute.
The shade. Oh, yes, I saw it. Gave me quite a start, let me tell you. Strange thing was, it seemed to be accompanied by a child.
You mean by a child?
Something near the shopping district that kinda sorta looked like a shade. You know, if you squinted.
The girl's story is not agreeing very well with the rest of the villagers' testimony. I think we should question her a bit further. Something is amiss.
How do you mean?
We are being lied to.
You think? Why?
I cannot say. Perhaps it is but an honest mistake. Or perhaps there is a good reason for the lie.
Listen, I'm not angry, but I need you to tell me the truth. Why did you lie about the shade?
I'm not lying. I saw it. It was big and scary and big.
Tell us this, then. In which location did you not see the shade?
You're weird. But, I guess I didn't see it near the Northern Gate or on the hill to the west.
There it is. That kid must have been trying to protect it.
A touching story, but humans and shades cannot coexist. We'd best defeat this monster while we can.
Agreed. It's dead. Let's go back to the client.
Having trouble sleeping knowing there were shades in our very town.
What have we got today? Which job should I give you first? The florist in Seafront has a job for you. Just a simple delivery. Easy peasy. I wrote down the client's location on your map, so head over there to get the details.
Oh God, it's over.
My life is over.
What's wrong?
Oh, hey, I remember you. You're the ones who helped us out way back when.
Seeing as we've come all this way, I suppose we had best ask, what is the matter?
I had a fight with my husband, and he ran away from home.
Mm-hmm, yes, yes. You may color me utterly flabbergasted.
But it's all that idiot's fault. I was saving up a bunch of apples, and he went and ate 10 of them.
That's actually sort of impressive.
Well, sure, I may have lost my temper a little, but I can't believe he just up and left. He's been gone for a week now, and it's...
All right, all right. We'll help you find him.
Really? Oh, thank you so much.
And here we go again. Shall we begin by asking around at the tavern like before?
We go to the tavern. We gotta go to the forest.
Where did that enormous ship even come from?
God damn it. Damn forest.
Hey, it's been a while. How are you?
Great, thanks. My Phrygias are selling like hotcakes.
Good to hear. But, hey, who's that?
That's my wife and son.
Wait, you got married?
Yeah, I decided it was time to move on. By the way, are you looking for work?
Always. What do you need?
I have a customer in Facade who needs a Phrygia, and I was hoping you'd make the delivery. My customer runs the material shop over there. I know it's a bit out of the way, but...
It's no big deal.
Thanks.
It's one of those that it's not gonna force me to not run or not whatever. Facade, huh? Item shop. Could deliver the Phrygia or whatever. Let's finish this quest anyways. We'll go to the Thief and Fire tomorrow. Yeah, we'll finish up with this quest, call it a night, pick up tomorrow, go to the bar there.
I say, do you remember that man?
Hmm?
He sent us to the Aerie to find his girlfriend.
Yeah, that was him, wasn't it?
Oh, neat! When did that happen? It sounds kind of romantic.
It didn't work out.
Sadly.
Hey, you expecting a Frisia?
Tak. Teruto. Sat.
Memories of what?
Iwaru oi datte. Ah, zasetora.
Oh, then I suppose I should tell you.
Eh. Kitteruwa. Jiatte. Kitakote. So, Zaligia, Sidasato. Yoristi, Zarikitawa. Dete. Suza, Tochi. Ato.
I can't believe she's become a shade.
How terrifyingly cruel.
Should we tell the man that his girlfriend is a shade now?
I honestly don't know.
Thoughts?
Oh, there.
Thank you.
deliver that freezer for you.
Hey, thanks. Here's your fee.
Listen, this isn't going to be easy, but I think you have a right to know.
What? No. Oh, no.
I am sorry.
If I would have just called her over here sooner.
Probably best to leave the poor man be for now.
Yeah.
I don't know, it just seemed like the right thing to do. Maybe we'll go to the bar tonight. Because I got a save from here somehow.
Hey there. I'm looking for the guy with the red bag.
Really? Is that couple fighting again?
Yeah, the guy took off and hasn't been seen since. I take it this isn't a surprise.
Hardly. Their arguments are legendary. We're actually considering selling tickets as a tourist attraction. Anyway, I think he's from that village with the library. Maybe he went back home.
Library? Oh, yeah.
I think his brother is a guard there or something.
Thanks for the tip. I'll see what I can figure out.
Say, you're pretty handsome. Care to buy a lonely woman a drink?
Yeah, I'm good.
Maybe he's just...
To think that couple's petty squabbles have become something of an attraction for the locals.
Doesn't surprise me in the least. Seeing people like that puts a little spring in your step, you know?
You humans truly are a maddening bunch. Such buffoonery does little more than wear this old tome out.
Searched the southern plains back when the wife ran off too, right?
I believe we did, yes.
Lots changed since then. So it's kind of nice when we find something that hasn't. The fact that couple is still arguing almost fills me with, I don't know, hope, I guess.
If you asked me, that particular couple could benefit from a little change.
You. What's up?
You're related to the ferryman who carries a red bag around, right?
Yeah. He's my little brother. Haven't seen him in a while, though.
A shame. Have you any idea where he may have absconded to?
Not a clue. Like I said, I haven't seen him.
Oh, that's unfortunate.
Oh, but the last time I did see him, he said something about using his ferry to deliver letters. Maybe you should try talking to someone at the post office.
I guess we could ask the postman over in Seafront.
Just once, I would enjoy receiving a quest that can be solved in the general vicinity of the Asker.
In the save, right next to the
I cannot believe
office.
How many trips we have made simply to track down a single man.
It's all right to do this kind of thing every now and then.
I only pray this is not the calm before some manner of storm. Say there, lad, have you ever penned a missive?
You mean a letter? No. I'm not big on writing. It always takes me forever to figure out what I want to say.
What's to figure out? One simply takes quill in hand and unleashes their soul upon the canvas of the page.
Whatever you say, Vice. Hey, postman. Oh, sorry. You're not him.
I'm sure as hell not. I just swung by to pick up a letter and wound up running the damn place. Anyway, you here for a package or something?
No. There's this couple who's always fighting, and the husband took off, so I'm trying to track him down. Ring any bells?
Sorry, pal. You're asking the wrong guy. Still, that's pretty weird. My buddy's daughter took off, too. Maybe running away is the cool thing to do now.
I find it exceedingly unlikely this pair of runaways is mere coincidence.
Any idea where she might have went?
That is the question, isn't it? Actually, you know what? I bet she went to check out the huge shipwreck that drifted into the inlet the other day. Not often something like that comes around. It's all the kids have been talking about.
We're definitely following it right here. We'll pick this up tomorrow. Good night.